Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is a brand new Q&A episode. And for this video, I received a question recently across social media. I think it's best to read it off the platform. Assalamu alaikum. Sheikh, could you please highlight the importance of sunnah prayers? Do we really have to pray them? Are we sinful if we avoid them? And how many units are there if we are to pray? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. We begin by praising Allah. We ask Him for His help. We ask Him to open doors of beneficial knowledge for all of us. And we ask Him to send His choicest of blessings and salutations upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wa sallam, his family members, his companions, and all those who tread upon his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. My dear brothers and sisters, when you look closely at the teachings of our beautiful deen, we see that along with every fard, along with every obligatory deed that has been prescribed upon us, whether it be the compulsory salah, the compulsory prayer, whether it be the compulsory fasting, compulsory zakah, or compulsory hajj, you see a corresponding nafil or optional act that has been legislated by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So all these aforementioned obligations are accompanied by similar optional acts. And these have been legislated to compensate for any flaw or to rectify any discrepancy that may occur in the fard act. And this is deduced through a narration that has been captured by the famous companion Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, who states that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is reported to have said, the first thing about which the people, and I'm paraphrasing the hadith, the first thing about which the people will be called to account from their actions on the day of Qiyamah, on the day of judgment, is as-salah, prayer. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all to offer our prayer, our salah, with excellence upon excellence. So our Lord the Almighty will say to the angels, even though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, He knows better, He will command the angels, look into the prayer of my slave and see whether he has offered it perfectly, or see whether he has offered it completely or incompletely, as to whether it is complete or whether it is defective. If it is complete, then the salah will be recorded completely. It will be recorded perfect. If it is, on the other hand, flawed or defective, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command the angels, see if there are some optional prayers offered by my slave. And if there are optional prayers to his credit, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, compensate the obligatory prayer by the optional prayer for my slave. Compensate the flaws, the discrepancies in the obligatory prayer by the optional prayers that my slave has offered. And likewise, all the actions will be considered. Similarly, this hadith is recorded in the book of Imam Abu Dawud rahimahullah. So based on this, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, we need to give utmost importance to the sunnah prayers that are in place. So as per the question of the questioner, it is sunnah. So if you perform it, you are rewarded. And if you omit it, you are not going to be considered sinful. Unlike the case with fard prayers. Now fard prayers, if you do it, yes, you are rewarded. But if you leave it, then you are sinful. There is no room for us to leave our fard prayers. But on the other hand, the sunnah prayers, they are of a lesser degree when it comes to obligation. But as you can see, it is of utmost importance that we fulfill it. Because when you look around, most of us, those who do not offer their fard prayers, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help them to offer them, because that is something that you have to offer. But when it comes to the sunnah prayers, a lot of us, the bulk of us, we offer our fard prayers, but we do not give enough importance. We do not attach enough importance to the sunnah prayers. And this is why it is important that we create this awareness. Now we have a beautiful hadith where the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is reported to have said, Allah will build a house in the garden in Jannah for whoever is diligent in observing 12 sunnah raka'at. This is the sunnah al-rawatib. These are the sunnah raka'at that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave a lot of importance to. So for whoever is diligent in observing 12 sunnah raka'at, and they are as follows. 4 raka'at before Salatul Dhuhr. So we start off with Salatul Dhuhr. You have 4 raka'at, 4 units of prayer before Salatul Dhuhr. And then you have 2 after Salatul Dhuhr. And then you have Salatul Maghrib. As for Salatul Asr, we will discuss it in just a bit. So Salatul Maghrib, you have 2 after Salatul Maghrib. 2 units of prayer after Salatul Maghrib. And then 2 after Salatul Isha. And 2 before Salatul Fajr. Once again, let's start off with Salatul Dhuhr. You have 4 units of prayer before Salatul Dhuhr. And 2 after Salatul Dhuhr. So 6 units there. 2 after Maghrib, then 8. 2 after Salatul Isha, 10. And 2 before the dawn prayer, before Salatul Fajr, totals up to 12 as per this particular hadith, which is an authentic one, and it is recorded in the book of Imam al-Tirmidhi, rahimahullah, and other books as well. So from this hadith, you see, my dear brother, my dear sister, by offering these 12 units of prayer, you are following the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wa sallam, and you are rewarded immensely by Allah azza wa jal. Just imagine every single day, 12 units of prayer, and you are securing residences for yourself in the lofty and beautiful garden of our Maker. Now as for Salatul Asr, in regards to Salatul Asr, you don't have a routine sunnah, but it is mustahab, it is highly recommended that one prays 4 units of prayer before the Asr prayer. Again, when you look at these 4 rak'at, they are of a lesser reward and significance when you compare them to the 12 sunan al-rawatib that we just discussed. These 4 rak'at before Salatul Asr, they are highly recommended. They're highly recommended, and I'm going to mention the hadith in regards to them. They're highly recommended. But when you compare them to the Sunan al-Rawatib, okay, as we mentioned at the beginning, you have the Fard prayers, which are right at the top. And then after the Fard prayers, you have the Sunan al-Rawatib. And after the Sunan al-Rawatib, you have these 4 rak'at, these 4 units of prayer before Salatul Asr. Now, in regards to these 4 units, we have a hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is reported to have said, Rahim Allah, may Allah have mercy. Look, my dear brother, my dear sister, who is making dua? The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, a lot of us, we tend to be very happy when someone makes dua for us. And you have people, you know, when they come to visit us, they would say, Sheikh, please make dua for me. Please pray for my health. Please pray for this. Please pray for that, you know. And we're very happy when someone makes a dua for us, like I said earlier. Now here in this hadith, you are observing that it's just not any ordinary individual who is making dua. This is the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet of Allah. Will his duas be turned away? The best of creation, the greatest of them all, the most beloved unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this Prophet of Allah is making dua. He is saying, Rahim Allah, may Allah have mercy, may Allah have mercy upon the one who prays 4 rak'at, 4 units before the Asr prayer. How long is it going to take for us to offer 4 units of prayer? Subhanallah. And by offering those 4 units of prayer, you come under this beautiful canopy, this beautiful dua of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You are securing the mercy of Allah. Therefore, don't let go of it, my dear brothers, my dear sisters. This hadith too is recorded by Imam al-Tirmidhi, rahimahullah, in his book, and it is an authentic hadith. Now, in regards to all of these voluntary prayers, you have to understand that as per the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, these 4 rak'at, 4 unit prayers are supposed to be offered two at a time. Now, for example, if you were to take the four units that I was just talking about, Salat al-Asr. Now, we are familiar with Salat al-Asr being a prayer where you have two tashahuds, yes, but one taslim. When I say taslim, what I mean is Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. You conclude your prayer with the fourth unit. But with the sunnah prayers, it is as per the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah highlights this, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah highlights this, that they are supposed to be offered two at a time. So the four units before Salat al-Asr, you will pray two units and then conclude the two units by giving your taslim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. And then you will stand up for the next two units and conclude those two units as well with the taslim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. And then you will go on to offer your Salat al-Asr. I hope it's clear. So with that, we conclude this video. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps all of us to adhere very firmly and strongly to the Sunan al-Rawatib. May Allah help us to offer them on time. May Allah Azza wa Jalla help us to adhere to the beautiful teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of our sins. May He accept our good deeds. And may He admit us into His beautiful and lofty garden. Ameen, ameen, wa akhir da'waya, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Jazakumullahu khaira. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.